Hi guys, Rev Jock here again, and welcome back to another episode of the Dumbarton. Adjective to use now. Celebration, I could say, on this episode, after what happened last season. This is episode 7. If you haven't watched the rest, please, you can find them on my channel. It should be in sequence. The first two are a little bit far-fetched, but after that, I've tried to keep it pretty realistic. So we got some good news. I've managed to extend the contract of Ross Docherty. It's up to 2028 now. So that's a bit of good news. I've also done the same with young Luca Vata, the Albanian defensive midfielder, who's 20 now, amazingly. I think it's going to be his season this year. I think he's going to come into the team a bit more. Ben Williamson, I've got him on a 3-year deal. So that's good. He's signed up till 2029. Calvin Miller, I've got on a 3-year deal up to 2029. Mark McKenzie, this was a big one. Now, this has cost me a little bit of money. I had to speak with Frank and the chairman last night. It was a heated discussion, I must say. I was for it. Frank was 50-50. The chairman was totally against it. I had to pull up Mark's stats for the season just gone, and the chairman eventually succumbed. So, I mean, he's got a loyalty bonus. It cost us quite a bit of money to keep him. But the good thing is, it's an investment, because I think there might be several clubs sniffing around him now. But anyway, that's done. Regan Hendry, I'm having a bit of trouble. He doesn't want to sign a contract. Oh, he did sign. Did he sign? Oh, I don't know. I'm a bit confused. I've done some of this last night, guys. Sorry. Dumbarton's 22-year-old central defender, actually he's a left-back at the moment, has left his agent Dale Hay. I don't know if that affects us directly at the moment. Right, I signed Liam Parker up on a 3-year deal as well, to 2029. If we get into the Premier League, Premiership, whatever you call it, he's got a 20% pay rise, so let's see. Here's a season review, what's just gone. What I'm going to do, Mark McKenzie's 37 goals for Dumbarton this season is a new Cinch League One record. I tell you what, he must be getting close to Kenny Wilson's record. I remember Kenny Wilson back in the day. Top goal scorer and award winner. Well done, Mark. Dumbarton players named in the team of the year, McKenzie, Mimna, and Devine, and Miller. All new signings. You know, I get the... if you're a Dumbarton fan watching this, you're probably getting a hump because I've brought in loads of new players, but I've tried to keep it realistic. I've tried to keep them like young Scottish players. It would be easy to go out and buy cheap Brazilian wonder kids and get to the Premier League, but, you know, it doesn't really happen for teams like us. So I'm trying to keep it as real as possible. It's partially real and partially make-believe. And me and Frank were talking last night about this. And, you know, after 3 pints, he's a bloody lunatic. But I said, Frank, just think, we're in the Championship. By the way, I did, when I showed you the English Premier League in the end of the last episode, I realised they'd only played 37 games. But I went back and played, well, I'll show you, actually. I don't think anything changed at all. I think the relegated teams were relegated. Anyway, there it is, if you're interested. Guys, I've been putting my hands in my pockets again. Made an offer for a guy from Arbroath by the name of Rhys Holden. He's a young striker. He's 21. 13 finishing. 12 dribbling. 12 heading. Acceleration. Fitness. Pace is okay. I think, I'm not sure. There's stuff going on behind the scenes with young Russell McLean. I think he's got itchy feet. So I think I'm going to bring in Rhys Holden as a backup to McLean and McKenzie. But also, when the day comes that McKenzie especially gets offered a bigger club and a bigger salary, that I've got a feeling young Rhys Holden could be the one to take over. So let's just start negotiations here. He's going to be a breakthrough prospect. Let's see, goal bonus, bring that down a bit. Unused substitute fee, that's got to... In fact, I'll get rid of that. It's going to be on. See if I can get a 2-year deal. There we go. Done and dusted. We just wait for Reese now to accept. Our bros were playing hardball. It's a long story, but I initially got him on a free transfer. Then our bros triggered the extension on his contract, so I had to pay a fee, unfortunately. I was hoping to get him in for zilch. Russell McLean, the player, isn't good enough. I don't agree with that. But Gregor, I want to offer a coaching job. And I can't remember how to do it. I think I've got to wait till his contract expires, which is in 4 days' time. So we'll come back to that. But I want to get him in as a coach. He's a good guy. He's been at the club for a wee while, you know, so I think it's only fair. There's not many of the old guard left. I understand that might be frustrating to some of you guys, you know. We're building a team for the future here, and they will stamp their own identity on Dumbarton. This was the initial page that brought me to Reese Holden. So the transfer value was initially zero. Look at this young Jack Collins. Let's just check him out. Did I get him on a... Right, let's see here. We're going to... Let's get rid of that one. And I'll keep that if we get him in the top division. Right, we got him up to 29 now. Sorry about that diversion there. Callum Hambrook, key player, could become better than Calvin Miller. Wow. Buchanan hangs up his boots. Enter. Job, coach, secondary job. I think I'm going to give him... Head of Youth Development. Secondary job, scout, immediate, let's give him a 2-year deal. How do you fancy that, Greg, old lad? Oh, he's not happy. Okay, he's a coach. Right, oh well, welcome to the gang, son. You'll be on the bench with me and Frank next week. Next season, sorry. 10 a quarter grand it's cost me. Reese Holden's on the door. I might play him in a couple of pre-season friendlies, see how he goes. Give McKenzie a rest. I'm going to have to go through the squad. There we go. Gregor Buchanan has officially signed his new contract with the club. Coach, senior squad coach. There you are. That's good, I'm glad. Right, as Gregor Buchanan has left the team, you need to select a new vice-captain. Now, I don't want to upset anyone. Let me think here. I think Harry Cochran's the man. Brett Long? Nah. Now, guys, I want your opinions on this in the comment section. Do I extend Brett's contract, or do I look for a slightly better goalkeeper? I don't know what to do. How long has he been at the club? Let's have a look here. He's been at the club, not too long, just a season before I came in. Got him on a free from Peterhead, East Fife, Cliftonville, Dundee United, Murrowwell. It's a hard one for me. I don't want to upset the boy. How old is he? 29. I think I'm going to look for a new goalkeeper. Sorry, son. I'll get the wheels in motion. This is my backup keeper. I'm going to keep the backup keeper, and then I'm going to look for a first choice goalie. Get this down a little bit. 20. I came for 12 months. I've had a bit of trouble with Russell McLean and Michael MacArthur. Neither of them want to sign a new contract. I've tried to trigger an extension and I don't know what's happening. I don't even know how to properly do it, to be honest. But we're hopeful. I did manage to get Finlay Gray. If he accepts, I've offered him a 2-year deal, I believe. So that's good. What else has been happening? Yeah, that one's looking good. So I'm going to... Finlay Gray has accepted the new contract. That's great. So we got him on a 2-year deal up to May 2028, which is nice. So Brett Long has left the club, unfortunately. Sad to see you go, son. But we're in a championship now. I think I need a slight upgrade. I also failed in my attempts to keep Russell McLean and Michael MacArthur. Both are available on freeze, which is bad management on my half. The problem when you're simulating a season ahead, the contracts just expire so quickly. If you're playing the full season, you know, like game by game, you get notifications, you know, like this guy's only got a year left in his contract and blah, blah, blah. But anyway, it's schoolboy error on my part, and it's Frank's fault, really. But we'll let it go. So we've lost McLean. Let's just see how this affects the tactics here. Got my kid. Is this new boy in yet? Let's see if we can find him here. Bring in Lukavata as well. Hanratty. Yeah, so we'll come back to the squad in a moment. There's a few other things I was thinking about doing. I had a chat with Stuart Carswell earlier today, and it's clear that the player has something he would like to discuss with you. Let's have a chat with Stuart. Look, it's clear I'm not very happy about this situation, and I've got absolutely no concerns about running my contract down and leaving on a free at the end of the season, unless something is done about it. I don't get what you want. Do you want a new contract? He's not happy. Let's see if I can give him an extension. He's probably unhappy at the club and doesn't want to sign a... Blimey. When's his contract expire? He's got a year. He's how old? 33 now. He'll be 34 next year. He's been a good servant to the club. 17, 27... Almost 10 years, you know, so I see how he feels in a year. I'll use him this year. And if he wants to leave next year, then Stuart, do what you got to do, son, you know. It's up to you. You chose not to speak to the Sky Sports journalist. Yeah, that sounds about right. Under the Bosman ruling. Carswell's going in a Bosman. Huh? Bristol Rovers want me. Blimey. I ain't going to weigh down there, it's nearly in Wales. Sorry guys, home is where the heart is, decline. Well, my chief scout, John Fraser, has signed a new deal. Another 2 years up until 2028. I think he's doing a decent job at the moment. Thank you, John. I'll see you later down the club. Paul Mackey, my director of football, has also signed on for another 2 years. Thank you, Paul. Harry the goalie, has given him a 1 year as backup. But like I say, I'm going to have to bring in a new first-choice goalkeeper. Matt Fenwick has signed on for another couple of years. Well done, Matt. Gabe Stewart, the scout, another year. My old assistant, Frank, a couple of years. Chief scout, John Fraser, yeah, been there, done that. Lara the physio, hi Lara. 2 years. Right, I'm going to go away in the background here and try and get myself a goalkeeper. The question is, do I approach, as you know, I'm an affiliate agreement with Rangers. I'm wondering if I could get a Rangers backup goalie in for a season until see how the young boy develops. Or do I try and pick up one, maybe 6-7k or so. Anyway, I'll come back to you on that, guys. See you in a moment. Cardiff have offered $3,500 for Jack Collins. Transfer may eventually rise to $7,000. Not interested, Cardiff. I've been trying to get a goalkeeper. It's been pretty difficult. I'm starting to regret letting Brett go, actually. I went to Rangers, but no joy there. Tried Celtic. I tried to get Connor Hazard. I went to Hearts. I tried to get a goalie from Hearts. And no joy as yet. What's he want to know? How do you feel your squad could be improved? I don't want to let people know I want a goalie. It'll bump the prices up. That's schoolboy stuff. I also tried to get... Blimey. I put a cheeky bid in for Tony Weston, the English boy at Rangers, and he's agreed to come on a trial. Let's see how that goes. He did turn me down 2 years ago. This could be a very good signing, actually. I wonder how much it's going to cost me. Bear with me, guys. This is quite a moment here. Negotiate contract. Oh, no. I can't pay that kind of money. Oh, if I could get him down to... six. Agent fee. Oh, I can't afford this. Do you think it's worth it? No, I've got to walk away. Sorry, I can't. I should have had a chat with the chairman about this. He's a good forward, this boy. And I think we could really... I can't do it. I can't break the structure. Well, I got Jack Collins on a 3-year deal. The Tony Weston thing may come back to haunt me because I think there's a decent player in there. Jordan Marshall, who's this boy? This could be a free transfer, fullback, 13 crossing, 12 dribbling, decent physicals, 29. He's a bit old, you know, I'm a bit of experience, mind you. I don't know what to do here. I don't know what to do. Offer trial. Let's see how that goes. Oh, West Brom want me now for a job. Blimey. I ain't going down to Black Country. I'll decline. Thanks, West Brom. But no thanks. I know you're a yo-yo team. No, I'm not going to take your advice there, Frank. Frank's pleased to seal the holding deal. It was me that sealed it, Frank. I know where you were. But yeah, Reese's coming in. So actually, you know... this is the trial. He's in for a trial. Let's see how that goes. See how Frank rates him. Unlikely to improve. Important player in his prime years. Let's see the comparison with... Dumbarton, Liam Parker. Jordan Marshall. Better technicals, better attacking, better speed. Liam's a better defender. Oh, this is a tricky one, this. I'll decide at some point. I'll get Frank to give him the once over. What's he asked me? Why did you decline the West Brom job? There you are. Does that answer your question, son? Rangers want to negotiate. Ah, this is the goalkeeper I made a bid for. Daniel Hoare Fernandez. Now, he's a bit old for my liking, but he's a decent goalkeeper. But, I mean, how can he... Look... I'm an affiliate. How can I can't afford to pay all that. Like if it's zero, first choice, goalkeeper, suggest. Come on, Rangers. Bloody hell. I can't afford to pay that. Ah, this is a guy I put an offer in for Barkas, the Celtic backup. Well, former Celtic backup, I believe. I see this is Dumbarton you're dealing with here. I can't afford these. No, I can't do it. The goalkeeping situation may come back to haunt me, and I can't start the new season without a decent goalkeeper. I might need to go down to the lower leagues in England, maybe League One and League Two in England, and try and pick up someone who's surplus to requirements. Well, what do you know? Apparently I'm waiting for a better opportunity to come along. According to Sky Sports, Lukavata, key player, could become slightly better than Regan Mimna. Rhys Holden could become slightly better than Mark McKenzie. Interesting. So still no luck on the goalkeeper front. I approached Exeter City, who had a young Scottish goalkeeper called Jude something. And they just wanted too much. He was willing to come, but Exeter wanted me to pay about $6,000 towards his wages a week or something. That's crazy. Exeter City. Anyway, I'll keep looking. I will get there. See, look. This is bloody hell. I knew this was going to happen. Frank recommends offering him a contract. Now, Frank, are you going to dip your hand in your pocket and pay for this? Because the chairman's going to have my guts for garters if... Oh, blimey. Let's see what we can do here. My client isn't... Oh, for fuck's sake. Excuse my language. Frank says sign him. But the sack your agent. Weston, sack your agent. How'd you sack your agent? I don't know, I can't remember. Anyway, I think it's dead in the water, Tony Weston. That's a shame. I think he's a decent striker. If Frank's telling me one thing, your chairman's shouting in my ear, saying, oh, don't do it, don't do it. You know, I'm caught in the middle here. Right. Back to the Jordan Marshall situation. Frank recommends I give him a contract. In fairness, going by this, he looks like very good cover for Liam Parker there. And also, I can play Parker. Don't forget, I can play Parker in the middle here. He's also a decent central defender. So if one of my two get injured in the middle, Parker can come in. Jordan Marshall can fill the fullback spot. Let's see what he wants. Star player? No. Important player? Maybe. Right, he's happy with that. I can't go a thousand. $575, and I'll give you a signing on fee and get rid of this top division thing. $25. No, is it? $825. And that you're my highest earner if you take that. Oh, God, what have I done? What have I done? Right, well, that's done. I may need to sell someone now. Who's this Cammy Ballantyne? He's a right back. I don't know how I'm in right back land. Who have we got? We got Scott McGill and Ben Wilkinson. Who have we got? Goalkeeper, we only got Harry. Up front. Oh, the trials and tribulations of a football manager. Oh, this keeps popping up, man. There is a World Cup going on at the moment. You'll notice that Scotland are not involved. Anything of interest there, you can pause the video and have a good look. England, Australia and Mali. Blimey. Austria, USA, Peru, Holland, Algeria, Thailand. Well, the squad are back. Let's welcome them. Welcome back, everyone. I've had a chance to think over the last few weeks, and I think I wasn't being ambitious enough in our last meeting. If all of you give 100%, there's no reason we can't finish in the top half this season. They don't like that. Okay, let's leave the expectations unchanged. That's what I wanted to hear. Blah, 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 blah. Smiley faces, happy. Get back to training. Done that. Welcome them back. Quest summary to inbox. Jordan Marshall has signed. You know, this one could come back to haunt me as well, I think, because I think I'm paying him a bit more than I should, really. Anyway, welcome in, son. Bit older, gives us a bit of experience in that fullback position. Let's get some focus. What's he a bit weak on? Let's have a look here. He's a fullback. He's not a wingback. He could be a wingback, which means that his crossing's not bad, dribbling's not bad. Corners, tackling, what's finishing, don't matter. Free kick taking, heading. Let's give him some corner kick training. There we are. Right, and I'll ask Mr. Graham to welcome him. There you go, son. All right, who's it? This is this goalkeeper I was telling you about, Exeter. Early signs of a quality signing. 23-year-old. It was just he's valued at 60 to 600. He looks very decent, you know, to be honest. Although his eccentricity is quite high. You know, I do quite like that, though. Let's just see what... I can't remember how the stumbling block last time. Right, I can't afford to buy him for sure. Let's see the loan. Nah, it's totally gone now. I don't know why it came up as a recommendation, to be honest. There's all sorts of little quirks in Football Manager 23, and they surface now and again. Right, Cole Smith has said, I've been told by the squad that they are not happy with your management of a team, and they wish to talk to you about it. We just won the league, guys. I mean, what more do you want? Unhappy players. Luke Graham, Mimna, Docherty, Williamson, Frizzle, Parker, Cochran, Devine. Some of the lads feel that the squad lacks depth in the goal. Well, I know that. I'm looking for a goalkeeper. Blimey. Right, get out of here. I've spent the last 6 weeks hunting for it. Well, 3 weeks. Hunting for a goalkeeper. And they're telling me we need a goalkeeper. Bloody hell. Ben Williamson, crossing, get in there, son. Attacking movement, good. Unlikely, blah, blah, blah. Callum Holbrook, knocks past the opponent. Yeah. Tick, 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 tick. Frank believes in Marshall's impact. Okay, good. Glad you're happy. It's costing us a fortune. See, look. He keeps popping up, Tony Weston. It's almost like they're trying to force me into paying over the top. I wonder what's happening in the World Cup. Are you interested or not? Dumbarton's stature in the game remains intact. That's good to hear. Right, see this, they keep doing this. He's a star player. Just leave it the way it is. Otherwise they're knocking him at the door. What'd you say, I'm a star player? You put me in port player. Blimey, it only seems like yesterday since the draw for the Premier Sports Cup was made. It actually was. Let's view the draw. I draw all teams. See where we are. I don't see us yet. Right, we're right down the bottom. I'm not sure if you can see this on your screens. I explained before, my laptop's 3x2 and YouTube crops at 16:9 or whatever. Anyway, it's complicated stuff. There it is. So I don't need to put the graphic up, right? Dumbarton Air, FC Edinburgh, Hibs and Queen's Park. So we got three championship teams and a Premier team and a League One team. I'm sure we've had easier draws when we were in lower divisions. I still got to get on the goalkeeper thing. I don't want to take you down that route because it can be tedious, you know, to watch the... you got to butter up agents and... You know, it's under a counter, let's buy them a pint of Guinness here and there. And tedious. Right, Finlay Gray's been training well. Well done, son. Keep it up. Who's not been training well? Hamburg. He'll improve. Good lad. Now we got a couple of friendlies coming up. I'll take you over to the schedule now, actually, and we can have a little look at that once he... Page refreshes. Schedule. We got a couple of friendlies, Stirling and Brechin, both away. So we're heading up the motorway. Then we got FC Edinburgh, Hibs, Queen's Park Air. We open the championship campaign against Kilmarnock on the 1st of August. So who's in the championship? Kilmarnock, Dundee, Queen's Park, Hamilton, Falkirk, Queen of the South, Air, Partick. Quite a decent league, I think. I think, you know, we're going to have to get a decent goalkeeper in quick style. Played two friendlies, beat Stirling Albion 2-0 with goals from Adam and Regan. A thing of note in this game, I started Luca Vata and he played very well, 7.6 rating. The second game, however, I rotated the squad quite considerably. Played Stuart Carswell, Calvin Orsi, Lee Gibson up front. Still a bit raw, young Lee. But anyway, we got a 0-0 draw. However, there is news. On the goalkeeping front, you'll be pleased to know we have signed a goalie. We have signed Blessing Oluyemi, who's a 21-year-old goalkeeper, potential to be a Premiership standard, and we got him on loan. Yeah, so we have a new goalkeeper. His name is Blessing Oluyemi, and we managed to get him on loan from Aberdeen. He hasn't made too many appearances for Aberdeen. In fact, he hasn't. He's made two. He did play 12 games for Hamilton and 34 games for Elgin City. Now, I think this is a good signing. 21. He can play as a sweeper keeper or a goalkeeper. But look at some of his stats here are quite incredible. 14 agility, jump and reach 12. His eccentricity is slightly high for a goalkeeper, which may be a concern. His reach is good. His reflexes are decent. Determination, decisions, bravery. I think all in all, it's a good signing. So we're going to bring Blessing in. We've got him for a year. So in that time, we can maybe sort out a permanent deal for a goalkeeper. This is the rotated squad for the last friendly. So we'll be coming back to tweak that a bit. Good news, Gregor Buchanan. We're going to send him for his Continental C license, as he's now part of the coaching team. Good luck, Greg. And Frank is excited by Blessing Oluyemi. I don't blame you, Frank. I'm excited myself. Now, also, we've been dipping our hands in our pockets again, and we've bought a young guy called Lennon Walker. Now, we're going to accept that, and then I'm going to show you about Lennon. Lennon Walker is 22 years old, decent potential, physicals are good, acceleration 15, pace 15, agility 14, balance 13. This is what convinced me. He can play here on the right, he can play as a 10 or a shadow, and he can play on the left. I think he's very versatile, and I think he's a very good addition to the squad. So, welcome Lennon. This is just clarification. We've sent Greg for his Continental C license. As you can see there, I have my Continental Pro license. Scott Wilson has a B license, there's a few A's there. So that's good. The club's in good hands. Liam Parker, best in training. Well done, son. Pat in the back. Luke Graham, criticise. Get your finger out. Don't do it again. See you later. Hearts are back in for Jack Collins. A 7,500 bid, rising to 20. This is the second bid. I didn't show the first one because it was so insignificant. They've upped it quite considerably. If it goes any higher, I might need to think about it. He hasn't really figured for me yet. He's actually, I think he's on international duty at present with the under-19s. If Hearts come back with a much improved offer, I may have to think about it. In the meantime, in the bin. We'll see what happens on that front. And we got a couple of live TV games coming up. Dumbarton at home to Falkirk. and Dumbarton away to Falkirk. 10,000 each, money in a pocket. I had a chat with Jack Collins earlier today and the player is frustrated at not being able to pursue a move to Hearts. Discuss issue with Collins. I don't want to lose you. What is it going to take to keep you? I need to be playing football in the Cinch Premiership at this stage of my career. You're 18, son. We'll see what happens. You know, they want me to suggest a fair, I'll say 60k. There's no way anyone will pay that much. But you want to play in the Premier League. I'll go to 50. Hang on. It's a bit footery, this. I'll say 55. The middle of what? No. I've upset you, but you know, so what? I'm past caring, son. I don't want to lose you, you're a good player. But you haven't come into my plans as yet. The groundsman has asked me if I want to make any changes to the current pitch dimensions. I've no time for stuff like that. As of today, we have sold 322 season tickets. That's very good. That's up quite a lot. There's good momentum at the club now. I can feel it. Just walking around the town, people with their little hats and scarves on, rosettes. Ah, now what's happened here? Mark McKenzie's got an injury. I don't want to give him an injection. I'll leave it to the physio. Means he's probably going to miss the first game, which is a bit of a nuisance. He may even miss the Hibs game at this rate. As you may be aware, at this time of the year, and bearing in mind we are in 2026, so it's the America, Mexico, World Cup, Canada as well. So, this is the second round. Austria beat Mali 4-0. USA won, England won. England won on penalties. There you are. You can have a good look there if anyone's interested. Germany beats Brazil. Sweden beat Denmark. Mexico beat Canada. Let's see the quarterfinals. Third round. It's all changed. Holland beat England 2-0. Belgium beat Morocco. Italy beat the Czech Republic. France beat Switzerland. Argentina beat Congo. Let's see the quarterfinals. Spain 1, Italy 2. I presume that's after extra time. Yeah. Holland 1, Belgium 0. Turkey 0, France 3. Germany 2, Argentina 1. Let's have a semi-final. Italy 2, Germany 1. Holland 4, France 3 after extra time. Sounds like a good game. Now the final. And the Dutch have finally won the World Cup, would you believe it? After three failed attempts. Is it three or four? Three. Holland 2, Italy 0. Well done, the Dutch. Right, well, I've got my goalkeeper. I'm going to tweak my squad now in the tactics section. And I'm going to simulate a season. So, I'll see you again next May. Well, it's been a season, I can tell you that. Now let me show you the league table. We somehow got into the playoffs. I'm going to show you now the way the season ended. At this stage here, we lost 1-0 to Dunfermline. I believe we were about 4 points behind Dunfermline with three games to go. And when it came down to the final game, away to Partick Thistle, Dunfermline were home to Hamilton Academical. Now we had to win and hope that they lost. And, as we'll see here, they lost 2-0 at home to Hamilton Academical. So Dumbarton are in a playoff. It's quite remarkable. There were stages at the season where I thought we were heading for relegation. I mean, from the 19th of December through to February, it was loss, loss, loss. The games we were winning actually were cup ties, if you look at this, by and large. So I mean, we started the season really well. We beat Hibernian 3-0 at Easter Road. We beat Queen's Park. This is in the Premier Sports Cup. Beat Queen's Park. Beat Ayr United on penalties. Started the league really well. Beating Kilmarnock. Drawn with Ayr. Queen of the South. Beating Falkirk. And losing to Hamilton. But let's get over to the competitions. So, we got a playoff game coming up against Ayr. In a Scottish Cup. Knocked out in a fifth round by Celtic. Premier Sports, we were knocked out in the group stage, unfortunately. And in the SPFL Trust, we lost the final to Hamilton. 1-0, 10,000 there at Fir Hill. So, wow, it's been an incredible season, but it's not over yet. And I've got a special treat for you. I'm going to actually play the games in the playoff. Now, we've got two tough games. We're home to Ayr United, then we're away to Ayr United. I'll see you back here in a moment for the home game against Ayr United. So, here we are, guys. The home match against Ayr United. The team I've gone with is Oluyemi, Marshall, Graham, Parker, McGill, Doherty, Minmaw, Cochrane, Frizzell, Miller and McKenzie. That's pretty much been my starting team most of the season, apart from a few injuries here and there, which I've looked back over, and thankfully no long-term injuries like last season, so we've been a little bit fortunate. Now I'm going to submit the team, and this is a big game for Dumbarton, a big, big match. It's always harder for the Championship teams to get up to the Premier League due to the amount of fixtures. Right, I need to change this here. I'm just going to put on key highlights, normal speed. Right, here we go. Right, come on, boys, we need this. We got the corner here. Oh, what's happened? McAllister's. Oh, it's a penalty. It's a penalty. Come on, son. Oh, it's a goal. 1-0 Dumbarton. We're 1-0 up. Regan Mimna. I didn't know what was happening there. I thought he was going to take the corner. He was over there with the ball in his hand. He scored a few penalties this season, actually. There's Marshall. Back to Graham. Long ball. No one there. Ferguson in goal for Ayr United. Oh, no, no, no. Walsh is through. Tom Walsh has equalised for Ayr. Fourth goal of the season. Wow, that's not good. Thankfully, no away goals. Yeah, so, I mean, what an end to a season it was. These three victories at the end just secured a playoff place. It was looking very bleak at one. Oh, no, Robbie Ure. Ayr United are 2-1 up. Well, such a promising start is now looking not quite so promising. I may need to think about substitutions if it stays like this. Or maybe just go a little more positive. Playing reasonably well. Mimna's got the 7, but that's probably because he scored the penalty. A couple of bookings. Oh, well, we got a free kick here. Oh, unlucky. Oh, I thought that was in for a moment now. So, looks like we're going to go in at half-time, one goal behind. They're picking up a load of bookings. I wonder if it's going to affect them in the second leg, if they're going to have any suspensions. Hopefully. Right, come on, boys. Big 45 now. All the good work you've done this season comes down to this, pretty much. Although it's still possible to go to Somerset Park and get a result. I've got faith in you. There's Mackenzie. Go on, son. Go on, Mark. Go on. Yaw, Mackenzie. What a boy. 40th goal of the season. I mean, this boy must be on the radar of some of the big clubs. They're going to have to get their checkbook out, and it's going to have to be a big check, I'll tell you. Doherty back to Graham. Long ball. No, the keeper's out. Oh, the keeper. Oh. Oh, God. How'd you miss that, son? That was a big chance, Miller. I'll tell you what, we're having a lot of the play in the second half here. There's Graham. Nice ball across. Miller. By, oh, Miller again, what are you doing? This is a big long highlight for not much, isn't it? There's McGill. Nice ball. Mackenzie, come on, Mark. Cochrane. Doherty. Parker. Is that a penalty? Red card. He's already been booked. A penalty, red card, a penalty. Blimey. Is it Mimna again? It is. Oh, no. Oh, I think that's the first penalty he's missed. Right, come on. We must make this extra man count. Time's ticking on. 66. In all honesty, a draw wouldn't be the end of the world, because I fancy us going down to Somerset. Nice sunny day and getting a result down there. There's Miguel. Go on, son. I don't usually watch the game. It's very slow, isn't it? It's Doherty. Oh, cleared. There's Parker running through. Cochrane out to McGill. McGill, nice ball on the frizzle. Oh, that was Mackenzie in the middle as well. This is another long highlight for not much. Ferguson in goal, big long boot. Right, come on, Cocky. Frizzle, Mackenzie. Miller, come on, son. Oh, that's three chances he's had, Miller. I'm just going to make a couple of changes here, hang on. I'm going to bring young Collins on for Miller. In fact, that'll do for now. They're playing reasonably well, creating enough chances. See if we get another highlight before the... I'll bring on Calvin Orsi. Here's a highlight. Parker with a free kick. Orsi. Orsi's through. Orsi scores. Calvin Orsi. What a substitution. Blimey. The Ayr United players are shell-shocked. Oh, it's been ruled out. Oh, no, what happened there? I was offside. Oh. Oh my God, what an anticlimax that was. I've got replays clicked on, but it didn't show the replay. I guess he was offside. Right, guys, I'll see you back here for the second leg. Well, hello everyone and welcome to Somerset Park, Ayrshire. And we're going to start the same 11 that started the game, the home tie. So here we can see the team. Same team. I was going to replace Calvin Miller with Jack Collins, but I decided against it. But we'll see how the game progresses. Put on a real show out there. Right, I'm going to just have to change the settings here. Bear with me a second. Oh, it's on key highlights. That's okay. Right. We're in the away kit today, by the way. There's Miller on the left. Nice ball in. What's the goal? Parker. 1-0. Liam Parker. Blimey. What a great start. 9 minutes in. Actually, why is there no replays? Replays. Goals disallowed goals. Sorry, right, we're back on there. Jameson on the ball. Baker, one of the bookies from the first game. Oh, one each. Tom Walsh again. I believe he scored in the first leg. I think it's two evenly matched teams here from what I'm seeing. I think this tie could go any way. Oh, so it's going to show the goal again. Not great, he cut us open right through the middle there. Right, come on Dumbarton, the big 45, we're on the attack here. McGill with the throw-in. Cochrane, McKenzie, oh, just over. I didn't even have a look at the bottom of the Premiership to see who we could be facing later on. What's he doing going down like that? Ferguson. Big long kick. McGill with a header. Cochrane. McKenzie. Go on, Mark. Oh, blimey. I thought he was offside there. Mimna, with a corner. Parker, McKenzie. Cochrane, oh blimey. This keeper's spending a lot of time doing his fancy kicks and things. Right, come on Miller. Hogg for Ayr United. I don't want to see the replay. Kieran, sadly. I got to say, Mr. Olayemi, I wasn't really happy with your efforts to get that there. This is looking like it might be a tough game. I knew AR were a good team. Now, I think I'm going to bring on young Jack for Muller. On my head be it. Even though he's got an assist. He didn't play badly, in fairness. It just the memories of the first leg. I mean, he could have sealed it for us. See, Air United's getting a lot of highlights here. I don't like this. Oh, here's one. Coming back now, Parker. Come on, son. Nice ball to McKenzie. No one in the middle. McGill. Cochran. It's a goal! Harry Cochran. Fourth goal of the season. I thought there was no chance there, but McKenzie found it. Look, McGill found a space on the edge of the box. Cochran was on a penalty spot. Beautiful, beautiful goal. Come on, Dumbarton, we can do it. 4-each on aggregate. The next key highlight is key. And Dumbarton have it. Right. Mimna's over the ball. Oh, blimey. It's a corner. Mimna takes a corner. Parker, oh, just over. Oh, 64. Mackenzie's looking tired. Do I risk taking him off and putting on Orsi? Or, I don't know. I don't know what to do. I might just let it run. Minutes 2-2. This could end up going to blinking penalties. Pick up. That's nice, nice and calm, son. Liam Parker. Back to Olayemi. I'm trying to leave McKenzie on as long as I can, but I don't know if he's going to last extra time. Oh no, what's going on here? Marshall. Come on, Cocky. There's McGill. Long ball down. Is McKenzie there? Has he still got the legs? Mark. Oh, Mark. Ah, oh, that was the chance. The doorway to the Premiership was open there, son. It's looking like it's going to extra time. This is another highlight here in the last seconds. Extra time. Right, we're going to have to make changes here, I think, because the legs are gone. I'll just pause it momentarily. Mackenzie's really gone. Parker's... who have we got here? I can put Devine in for Parker. Mackenzie. Is it going to be Orsi or is it going to be Holden? I'm going to stick Holden on. Who else might need Cocky? I'll put young Vata on for Mr. Cochrane. And let's go, lads. You know, you've given your all this season. I'm proud of you, whatever happens. No one had us down as playoff material. I'll bring on Carswell as well. McGill with a header. Graham. It's Holden. Oh, Holden. Blimey, that was a chance. I think McKenzie would have scored that. Although he missed the one a moment ago, so who knows. Right, half time. Oh, I hope this doesn't go to penalties. Blimey, can you imagine? I don't actually know if I've played a penalty shootout in this version of the game. Oh, we got a highlight here. Carswell with a throw-in. Graham. Carswell. Holden. Oh. It's a bit ambitious, son. A bit ambitious. Oh, it's going to penalty kicks. Right. I've no idea what I'm doing here, really. I've got to pick the ones that seem to be quite good with penalties. Adam Frizzell. Reese Holden. And like Graham. Oh, I better pick another one just in case. David Devine. I don't want old Blessing to take one. Carswell could seal it with that penalty. Right. Team talk. Stay calm. Back yourselves. We'll be fine. Great words from Frank. Right, here we go. Mimna with the first penalty. Remember, he missed one as well. Lovely penalty, 1-0 Dumbarton. Now here's Sadler for Ayr United. Boo! And he scores, one each. It's Docherty now for us. Come on, son, bury it. Straight down the middle. That's brave. Kake now for Ayr United. I can't see the goalie. The scorecard's right over the goalie. That's bad directing. Here's old Frizzell. Come on, son, we need this one. Oh, it's just in off the post. Blimey. Now, here's Jameson for Ayr United. We could do with a safe here, Blessing. No, it's a good penalty right in the corner. Right, who's this now? Holden. Come on, son. No messing. Oh, he's missed it. Ayr United with a penalty now. And he scored. So it's down to Stuart Carswell. Maybe somewhat appropriately. I think it's Carswell. Is it? Oh no, it's Graham, sorry. It's down to you, son, if we... you've got to score this. And you do, well done. Now we just got to hope that Ayr United miss. And it's Kelly walks up for Ayr United. Does he look confident? I don't know. Oh, he's missed! Blessing Oliyemi. What a hero. I thought it was an easy save, to be honest. Now, here's Devine. Oh, see, I can't see the goalkeeper. Yes! Oh, the pressure shifted now. The pressure's on Ayr. Well done, son. David Devine. Take a bow, son. And it's Milne. Is it Milne? I can't see here. My glasses have steamed up. Oliyemi! We've won! We've won! Oh, we've won! Oh! Blimey! That was nerve-wracking. Team talk. Nice work, everyone. That was good. Oh, that was excellent. Oh, absolutely fantastic. Dumbarton, Dumbarton, Dumbarton. Right, guys. I'm going for a coffee. I'll see you in a wee while. Well, after the epic day down at Somerset Park, it was Dundee who were next. And this is what happened in the first leg. Miller down the left, inside. Cochrane, and Cochrane scores. Fantastic goal by Harry Cochrane. Dundee were soon level, however. Bit of a mistake by Blessings. So then it was all up to Dens for the second leg, evenly poised at one each. I was very lucky during the playoffs, actually. I managed to keep the same lineup, and McKenzie chips, dinks in a little opener there. Doherty with a through ball, Miller nicely taken down. Miller crosses. Frizzell, 2-0. And that's how it ended, unbelievably. So, it was all on to the relegation playoff final. And in the final, it was Ross County. Archibald crosses, Davies. You can see the score at the top, so it's pointless getting excited about it. I played the game already. But a lovely goal by McKenzie to make it one each. County go ahead. Davies again. Mibner to Collins, McKenzie again, Mark McKenzie. Then it was all up to Dingwall for the second leg. And unfortunately, it was just a bridge too far for Dumbarton. Ross County dominated really from start to finish. Winning 2-0. So all in all, a very good season for Dumbarton. And let's just have a look around the the leagues in the world. So it's the 29th of May 2027. And finally we have a different winner in England. It's Liverpool, Man City second, Arsenal third, Villa fourth. Is Unai Emery still at Villa? He is. And who's the Liverpool manager? Marcelo Gallardo. And is Pep still at City? Yes. Relegated Derby, Norwich and Brentford. No one unusual in the league, really. Who won? Milan win Serie A. Real Madrid win. How about UEFA Champions League? Round of 16. Arsenal beat Leipzig 4-0. Liverpool beat Porto 4-0. Man City win 3-0. Quarter final. Real Madrid beat Arsenal. Liverpool beat Juventus. PSG beat Bayern. Barcelona beat Man City. Semi final. Real Madrid 2, Liverpool 2. So the final. Real Madrid v Barcelona. And it's not been played yet. It's played today, I believe. Okay. Well, that's about it, guys. Very good season. We're trying to get Oliemi, blessing, Oliemi back on loan, but I think it's very doubtful. Aberdeen want a bit too much. I can't afford them. And I've tied up a few of the members of the squad. So we go again next season. I mean, we the good parts were very good. When we were bad, we were very bad. But we go again and we try and get up into the Premiership. Thanks very much. See you.